Shivaji Group of Institution. Myself, Hitesh Deepani, your chemistry teacher. Today, we are discussing the chapter matter and its composition. On the last time, we have also discussed this chapter. We are starting from the part from which we have finished in the last time. Now, we will discuss about the states of matter. There are three states of matter: solid, liquid, and in solid, the definite shape and definite volume is there. And it has any number of free surfaces. Solids have a definite shape and a definite volume. And it has any number of free surfaces. In case of liquid, the liquids have a definite shape. Sorry, liquids have a definite volume, but it has not a definite shape. It has only one free surface. Liquids have a definite volume but not definite shape. It has only one free surface. In case of gas, it has neither definite shape nor definite volume. Okay, it has neither definite shape nor definite volume, and it has no free surface. Okay, three states of matter: solid, liquid, and gas. Now we will discuss about the arrangement of molecules in solid. We take the example of a steel weight. In solids, the molecules are very tightly packed. This is the first point of arrangement of molecules in a solid. In solids, the molecules are very tightly packed. Second point, as the intermolecular spaces are very less, that's why the force of attraction between the particles is very high. Third point, because the force of attraction between the particles are very high, the solids at the molecules of solids attract each other with a strong force. Because the force of attraction between the particles is very high, the force of the molecules attract each other with a strong force. Fourth point, because the molecules attract each other with a strong force, that's why the solids are rigid and hard. Because of all these properties, we can conclude that solids have a definite shape and definite volume. Okay, we have discussed about the arrangement of molecules in a solid state. Now, we discuss about the arrangement of molecules in a liquid state. We can take the example of milk. Okay, in liquids, the molecules are lesser tightly packed in comparison to solids. Because the intermolecular force of attraction, intermolecular spaces are less in comparison to solids, the molecules are not attracted to each other with a large force. The force of attraction between the molecules is less in comparison to solids. Because the force of attraction between the molecules is very less in comparison to solids, the molecules of solids are not rigid and hard. They take the shape of the container in which they are filled. Because they take the shape of the container in which they are filled and the intermolecular force of attraction is less in comparison to solids, thus molecules of liquids move here and there in the container in which they are kept. Because of these points of conclusion, we can say that liquids have a definite volume but not definite shape. The definite volume of liquid is due to the number of molecules which remains same whatever the vessel is there in which they kept, and they take the shape of the container in which they are kept. That's why they do not have a definite shape. Then we will discuss about the arrangement of molecules in a gas. We can take the example of air. In gases, molecules are not very much less tightly packed in comparison to solids and liquids. Because the molecules are not very tightly packed, the intermolecular spaces are very large in comparison to solids and liquids. Because the intermolecular spaces are very large, that's why the force of attraction between the molecules is very less. The force of attraction between the molecules is very less. That's why the molecules of gases move here and there randomly, and the movement and the motion of particles of movement of gases is known as the Brownian motion. Okay? This is because, and this from these points of arrangement of molecules in a gas, we can conclude that gases have neither definite shape nor definite volume. Okay? So, rest of the part of this chapter we will discuss in the next class. Thank you, students. You have to go through these points which I have discussed.